Hello students, today's topic of discussion is integration. Now, integration is the reverse process of differentiation. Its geometrical interpretation can be a summation over a specific range. Now, in this definition, I call it in this statement, there are two sub-statements. You may say integration is the reverse process of a differentiation and its geometrical interpretation can be a summation over a specific range. Let's understand what it talks. Let us say I am showing a graphical representation of a speed, let us say in meter per second along the vertical axis I am showing, and the time taken in seconds along the horizontal axis I am showing. Let us imagine that the speed is a constant. So, with respect to time, the speed is not changing. And what is the distance traveled? See, if I divide this into a certain intervals, delta t, let us say. Now, the distance traveled, let us say this is delta t, and next another delta t, another delta t, another delta t, and so on. Now, what is the distance traveled in time delta t? That is nothing but v multiplied by delta t. Isn't it? Distance upon time is equal to velocity, we know. So, distance is equal to velocity multiplied by time. Now, velocity multiplied by time is the distance traveled. And this much distance is traveled in a delta t time. Now, what is the total distance traveled? What I'll do is the distance traveled in the next delta t time and the distance traveled in the next delta t time, and I will go on adding this. Okay, so finally what I'll get is, if I want to find out the distance traveled within this much time, what I'm doing is v delta t plus v delta t plus v delta t, all these areas I am adding, and finally I am getting this much area, right, which is nothing but vt. Now mathematically I am writing that as distance d is equal to v delta t, what I have explained you already. Then the total distance traveled is, let us say if I am dividing this total area into n number of parts, then summation of I is equal to 1 to n vi delta t, I can write this, right? Now see, here it says that it is the geometrical, its geometrical interpretation can be a summation over a specific range. Now if I just say it is time is equal to 0 to time is equal to, let us say, 10 seconds, then 10 times I am adding that up and I will get the total distance traveled. That is understandable. But where here this no picture of integration, right? Now integration comes into play when, see here, velocity is, we can express this in terms of velocity, can be expressed in terms of a time. However, with respect to time, velocity is not changing. This is constant, and that is the reason why this is the, with the simple process we can find out the vt, v delta t, v delta t we are adding. Or simply, if we want to find out 0 to 10, this 10, whatever is the time gap, multiplied by v, then I will get the whole distance traveled at one go. It is as simple as that. However, if the velocity also is varying with respect to time, that means your v is equal to a function of a time which is a variable quantity. With time, let us say time I am taking along x-axis and v in meter per second I took along y-axis, and the velocity curve, now the velocity is varying in such a way that the vt curve is a, the vt curve is not a straight line. It's not a straight line parallel to the axis, and not even a straight line not parallel to x-axis. It is a curve. In this place, in this case, what we have to do? Again, the same process we are following. That means we are dividing it into huge number of parts, but we are doing v delta t for this plus v delta t for this for v delta t for all the reasons when we are doing v delta t. Let us say every part is a delta t like that. So v delta t, whenever we are adding all these things, this much space you are seeing, this much area from the total area is missing. Now everywhere little missing, so it the result doesn't become so much accurate. To meant that what we are doing, we are making delta t approaching 0. That means
the strips are of infinitesimally small thickness, okay, then what we are doing, again Vi instead of a delta t, we are writing V dt, integration of Vi dt within certain limits, let us say it is t1 to t2, sometime to sometime. Then we are calling this integration of Vi dt from t1 to t2 is the total distance traveled. So this is the process for integration. Let's make it a little more generalized. This is not only for velocity and time, but if we are taking a curve where any one variable is changing with respect to another variable. Let us say this is y and this is x and this is the curve. This is y is equal to a function of x, and y is equal to f of x. When we plot that curve, let us say this is coming. Now between two points A and B, let us say we want to find out the area. So for this we are taking any two points, let us say this is C, I am erasing this to make some space, this is D, and the coordinates of C is, let us say, x, y, and D is, see, C plus, this is, say, let us, delta x. It is a very small one. I am showing this much big to make you understand, but it's a very small gap. So let us say x plus delta x and y plus delta y are the coordinates of the point D. Then from here to here it is delta x, from here to here it is delta y. Axis, let us call E and let us call this F. Therefore, area under the curve A C D B is given by summation of y I delta x I is equal to 1 to n. Suppose I am dividing like this into n number of parts. So I is equal to 1 to n y I multiplied by delta x, or A is equal to integration of y dx. See, delta x is this much and we are reducing it almost to 0. Delta x approaching 0. So it is so small, infinitesimally small, almost 0. So y dx, let us say E is, from here to here is A. Then we can call it at E, x is equal to A, and at F, let us say x is equal to B. Then we can write it as A to B. Within the limits A to B, the area is given by integration of y dx within the limits A to B. And that much is equal to integration of y is equal to a function of x, f of x dx A to B. This is nothing but the area at B. Area at B minus area at A is the area between A, E, F, B. This region, area of the region A, E, F, B is this much. So what I said, if I write, let me erase it to make some space. So from here, I am showing it. So this is area at, or let us call total area at x is equal to B minus total area at x is equal to A is equal to area of region AEFB. AEFB. So the concept is clear, right? But the integration is the reverse process of a differentiation. This statement is not yet clear. So we will check it through one example, simple algebraic example first, then we will see it conceptually. Let us see a basic formula of integration for simple algebraic function. Let y is equal to f of x is equal to x to the power n. Here, according to the formula, implies that integration of y dx is equal to integration of x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 is the formula. And if the same formula is within certain limits, which is called definite integral, so within the limits, let us say, again y dx only we are saying, within the limits a to b, let us say, this will be equal to integration of x to the power n dx between the limits a to b is equal to what? X to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 within the limits a to b. So what to, how to solve it? Instead of x, you put the higher limit first, b to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 minus, put the lower limit in place of x, a to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So this will be the final answer. If it is a definite integral, that if some limits are given, then we can find this out, or simply it is x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 is the solution of y dx. Now let's take a very simple example. Let y is equal to x square y dx. Now simply we are going to apply that thing. So integration of y dx is equal to integration of x square dx is equal to x cube upon 3. See, x to the power 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, that is x cube by 3 plus c is the answer. Some constant has to be there. Why we are saying this? See, here it was saying integration is the reverse process of a differentiation. You have taken these things, I assume, so I am erasing it. See, integration of x square dx is equal to x cube by 3, but what is the differentiation of this RHS? So d by dx of x cube upon 3 is equal to how much? So 1 by 3 constant you took out, and x cube is 3x square, right? 3 got cancelled, x square. Now see, x square's integration is x cube upon 3, and x cube upon 3 is a differentiation with respect to x is x square. So now did you understand, integration is nothing but the reverse process of a differentiation. Whatever integration you take, whatever is coming, the LHS, integration of something is equal to, let us say, integration of x square you got in this case is x cube upon 3. And differentiation of x cube upon 3 is x square. So whose x square's differentiation is x cube upon 3, and x cube upon 3's differentiation is x square. Now you might have made some idea about this statement, which says integration is the reverse process of a differentiation. Now you remember, to be more accurate mathematically, I always said that the answer should be x cube upon 3 plus c. Some constant has to be there. Now let us see what it means. Of, I am writing diff for differentiation. Differentiation of x cube upon 3 plus 2. What is the differentiation? Tell me. This is, see, 1 by 3 you kept aside, x cube 1 by 3 you kept aside, multiplied by 3x square plus 2, constants differentiation is 0. So again this is coming x square only, right? Again find now differentiation of, let us find out, x cube upon 3 plus 7. Find out what is the differentiation. Again 1 by 3 multiplied by 3x square plus this constant differentiation is 0, and again it is coming x square only, right? Now see, x cube upon 3 plus 2's differentiation also, differentiation also is x square, x cube upon 3 plus 7's differentiation also x square. So x cube upon 3 plus any constant you take, that's differentiation will be x square only. That is the reason when we are finding the integration of x square, this side integration of RHS should be x cube upon 3 for sure, but plus or minus any constant may be there, that doesn't matter. That is the reason to be very accurate, why dx cube upon 3 or whatever the differentiation we are finding, whatever the integration we are finding, plus c when the constant of integration is kept. It's very simple now.